In this video, I'm going to explain to you the difference between Docker and Kubernetes. Welcome to the sixth lesson of Docker from Zero to Infinity series. My name is Raghav. Let's get started. First things first, it is wrong to compare Docker to Kubernetes. They are not alternatives to each other. Both these technologies solve different problems. They have different use cases. And in fact, you can combine them to work together to build a powerhouse of infrastructure. Now let's compare Docker and Kubernetes. After I just told you that it's wrong to do so. Docker is a technology to create and run containers. It allows you to take your application and put it into a package that can be run on any computer reliably and in an isolated environment. So Docker is a container runtime. Kubernetes is a platform to run and manage containers at scale. You can use it to run Docker containers or even other runtimes such as Containerd. In other words, Kubernetes is a container orchestrator. Now, there is a bit of an overlap. Docker allows you to run containers. Kubernetes allows you to run containers. The difference comes at scale. If you want to run 4 containers on your local computer that don't have complex needs, Docker run is probably fine. But if you want to run 20,000 containers across 500 servers in 3 different data centers, you're going to need an orchestrator. Coming to use cases, Docker is mostly involved during the development and testing phase of an application. So, for example, you can use it to create consistent development environments. When you're developing a microservice on your local machine, you can run the service and its dependencies like database or cache in their own containers. Then your teammates can also run the whole thing on their workstations. You won't have the problem of it works on my machine. Docker is also super useful in CI/CD pipelines, where you get consistent builds and testing across different environments. Kubernetes comes into play when you deploy an application to production or other environments. It runs and manages the containers across a fleet of machines. It takes care of things like scheduling, resource management, scaling, automation, access control, and other things that you only need in production environments. So it is super useful when you want to deploy multiple microservices with high availability or data stores with strong durability guarantees. It can also be used to run big data workloads such as Apache Spark or even run something smaller like cron jobs. Basically, if you want to run processes on multiple computers, Kubernetes is more suitable. Docker has a client-server architecture. The server, aka the daemon, must be running on all servers where you want to perform Docker operations. But a daemon manages its own host machine only. Multiple daemons running on their respective host machines cannot coordinate with each other. They need an orchestrator for that. This means if you run an application using just Docker, you can only scale out vertically. You're limited by the capacity of that one host your app is running on. Kubernetes has a master worker architecture. The master node is responsible for managing the cluster. It includes components like the API server, controller manager, scheduler, and many more things. Basically, it does the administrative tasks of maintaining your cluster. Worker nodes are the machines that actually run container workloads. They receive instructions from master about what containers to run or stop. Workers have a container runtime like Docker or Containerd. They also have kubelet that communicates with the master, kubeproxy, and some other components. Because you can add more workers to a Kubernetes cluster, you can scale out your application horizontally by deploying more containers on more machines. When it comes to management, Kubernetes is a whole beast. It is a very complex piece of software with the potential to manage your entire infrastructure. But it is not an easy task to operate Kubernetes. It costs a lot of money, and sometimes you need whole DevOps teams to manage your cluster. But it is open source, so there's no licensing fees for using Kubernetes itself. Docker, on the other hand, is a lot less complex. It runs even on my laptop, and I have pretty much no maintenance overhead. But Docker's complexity shows when you're developing images for your applications. The code can get really tangled, but in most cases, it is up to the developer to fix such spaghetti. Docker itself is free to use, but Docker Desktop has licensing fees for large enterprises. So be sure to check the pricing. So you see, Docker and Kubernetes are not enemies. They can actually work together to benefit you a lot. Don't compare them with each other. Instead, compare Docker with other container runtimes and compare Kubernetes with other container orchestrators. So, can you comment below and tell me what are the three biggest differences between Kubernetes and Docker Swarm? Let's test your knowledge. In the next lesson, you're going to learn how data storage works in Docker using volumes. Until then, keep leveling up your DevOps skills with me. Drop a like, subscribe to my channel because I bring you the best and the most interesting content from the world of DevOps. See you in the next video.